Thank you all for showing up for PICA.
Hi everyone, my name is Kristen Kennedy. I'm the visual art curator at PICA and also one of the artistic directors alongside Roya and Erin. Thanks for being with us at Happy Hour. It's Thursday, it's the big lead up to our event on Saturday, and each day we'll have lectures, new video content, and DJ parties. So thanks for being with us. I'm here to introduce three video works by Sarah Magenheimer, Daniel Godinez-Nivon, and Ryan Trecarton and Lizzie Fitch. Each night we'll release new content, and then we'll screen the work on Saturday as part of a larger program. Now, one note to make about Ryan Trecarton and Lizzie Fitch's work: Thursday, Friday, and Saturday will all be unique works. Thursday and Friday, we're releasing small new clips, and then on Saturday, a full-length piece that's a new work in progress. We're so lucky to have these artists respond to our call to make work in these micro commissions, and we hope that you enjoy them. Have a good night.
What am I going through right now? The panhandle of isolation?
Don't mess with the Middle West, bitch.
Colony?
Hi. I'm Colony Panderson.
Colony.
Thank you. My name is Marcus Fisher. I'm an artist and musician based in Portland, Oregon. For the last 20 years that I've lived in Portland, I've been fortunate enough to experience so many amazing events and exhibitions organized by PICA, things that I never would have found had it not been for them. Every year when the TBA catalog shows up in the mail, I look forward to leafing through it to try to spot some familiar names and faces. But more often than not, I find myself gravitating towards the unfamiliar ones, ones that I have no background with, because I know it's going to be something special. But you know, PICA is so much more than the time-based arts festival. They provide year-long programming, showcasing artists, local, national, and international, from a wide variety of different backgrounds and disciplines. And beyond that, they also provide safe space for people to meet and gather outside of their normal programming. I'll never forget how in the days after the 2016 election, when a lot of us were feeling lost and disenfranchised, PICA opened their doors to let people gather and meet. And isn't that really the role of the arts, to foster inspiration and exchange of ideas? I find that in this uncertain time, when we don't know what the world is going to look like moving forward, we have to look for groups that we want to see continue, groups that provide a service to all of us. And you know, we're so lucky to live in a region with a strong arts community. And that community would look so different if it weren't for the volunteers, the supporters, and the organizations that make our community stronger. You know, I owe a deep debt of gratitude to PICA, not only for opportunities they've provided me, but also for decades of experiences and inspiration. I have no idea what my work would look like if it wasn't for PICA.